Hi, Don Monroe here. I wanted to share with you today some of the sticky situations I've run into creating Facebook events on my business page. And I bet some of you are having these as well. I'm set up here ready to share with you. So I am, you've got to be sure that you are setting this up, first of all, on your business page versus your personal page. You get different settings when you do that. So when I create the event here, you get to choose online versus in person. And what I have found is that I need to create it in person first and then switch it to online. Otherwise, I couldn't get my ticketing links and things in there. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to go in person, and I've already started setting one up here. This is a draft of an event that I'm going to do later in the year. And so I'm going to go ahead and walk through it. Let's see, make sure all this is right. And go on to next. Let's see. It's got on the business page, it's got some categories. It doesn't have just a business category. So I do call this networking. This makes sense for me and with the organization I'm doing it with. And then I'll go on next. Now I go ahead and fill it in as a physical location first. I'm going to switch it later to online, which is what it is. But I had some trouble with this, and I bet I'm not the only one. Let me go ahead and swap this one out and upload the right branch approved graphic that I usually use. And here's where I had the problems. I wasn't getting this admission ticket link where I want to go and connect it over to Eventbrite or wherever. Now, I don't actually have the link for this yet, so we can just go to Eventbrite. And for now, this is a brand new one I just agreed to do. So I'll pick up a link. Oh, for heaven's sakes, there we go. So let's go to some that I've got liked, and I can get this to this quick. Go to one within the organization. I don't know if you've noticed this, but you can go to a specific organization, and when you click that particular organization that's hosting, it brings up more events from that organizer at the bottom. And so this is actually the page where it's eventually going to show up. So for now, as a holding place, I'm going to put that as my ticketing link in there. I'll go back and edit it once that gets posted. But I'm going to go ahead and hit save here. Now, this is the part that I had trouble getting to when I was doing a virtual event because it wanted to connect it to the actual like Zoom link. I don't want to give out the Zoom link yet. I don't want to build that in here. I want them to go and register, and then we'll share the Zoom link with people that actually pay and register. Now, there's a couple other things in the event settings. You may want to add a co-host. And let's see if it will let me add our Texas branch. Sometimes I pulled it up here so I could type it just like it. Sometimes it's good about that stuff, other times not. So depending if that's set up as a business page or a community group, you may not be able to tag them as a co-host. But let's do one with my neighbor business, Penn Publishing, and this is how I could add a co-host. Now it will go out to them, but I tell you, this is something else I have found with the Facebook events, is that it doesn't automatically notify them. They weren't seeing it easily in their business notifications. So what I started doing was actually sending a link to those people that I share events with and say, hey, would you just mind visiting the event and making sure to accept the co-hosting? Because it's great if you co-host with someone, it will populate on your business Facebook page and their business Facebook page. If you're having trouble getting these settings, it might be because you accidentally made it from your personal profile on Facebook. Okay, this group is not actually co-hosting, so I'm going to take them back off, but that shows you how to do it. And then you can set your settings here. Do you want to show the guest list? Who can post? I don't mind if others post. I don't need to necessarily approve them. I would allow people to ask me questions. Now I'm going to hit save here. Now at this point, I can save it as a draft, or I could go ahead and publish the event. I'll show you right now as I go ahead and publish the event. What this is going to do is offer to make this an online event. There's also another place, if you get back in to edit it, it'll say switch to online. And this is what I recommend doing. Otherwise, you have trouble getting to that admission ticketing link, and it's so frustrating. So convert it to an online event. And there it is, ready to go. I could go ahead at this point and share it and do the things that I need to, but my ticketing link is working in here now. I would also say that if this is one that you are ready to share, share to pages and things, you've got all your settings in there to do that, but it is showing up as the online event now. So you are ready to go. I really hope this helps you. The problem is if I go back into edit and I get into that location page, it is very frustrating. It wants a Facebook Live, which is not what I'm doing. It wants a link to the actual Zoom event. When I used this, it was difficult to get to the actual admission setting, how they register. So I would switch to in-person. If you're having this trouble, use that admission ticketing area and then come back to an online event. Okay, my friends, I hope that helps. Be sure and subscribe.